In this short video, I will share my experience with the Stable Diffusion image to video model until now. The model's recommended resolution is 1024 by 576 pixels, and there are two versions of it. One capable of producing 14 frames, and the XT, the model that I use, is capable of producing 25 frames in total. Also, there is no possibility of text prompt at the moment, so the starting image is crucial for the output. The changes of the parameters do not give a lot of freedom for controlling the output. As I understand it, the motion bucket ID value has to do with how much motion there will be in the output video, and the augmentation level has to do with the noise levels and therefore the variation from the input image. So lower values means less variation and smoother motion, but I might be wrong, of course. And there are many cases where I could not remove erratic movements and transformations of some images, even with zero or near to zero motion, bucket IDs and augmentation level. Of course, since the SDV model is rather new, the approach and the methods are many times experimental, and a lot of things need to be tested and improved. Other than the SDV model that is running from a local Comf UI installation, I am using Photoshop for compositing and retouching images, Topaz AI Video for upscaling and frame rate change of the video clips, Move to Move and Reactor in an automatic 1111 for face swapping of images and videos. All the images of this video were produced with the use of Realistic Vision, a SD1.5 based model with the help of the After Detailer and ControlNet extensions and ControlNet IP adapter models. I often use a part of the produced clip in a video editing program, like Resolve, to overlay it in the source image. I have tested Pika Labs and Runway a bit, and I think that the SDV has already the potential to be a competitor even without the text prompt. I have tested more Pika than Runway, to be honest, since Runway free video generations is limited, and some images that the SDV model failed to produce non-erratic movement clips, Pika handled them more graciously. However, there are occasions that the SDV model produced better results with other images. Links and extra info will be at the description of the video.